see, and they don't really help the children with portion control, and it's just, it's out of alignment. And so we look at something like that, simple, and she was talking about how the nutritionist on the campus actually comes up with the ideas of the food, and that they don't really make any sense, they're not healthy. And then the nutritionist, I asked her, I said, you know, just based on what you first feel about her, if you tune in, would you say she lives in alignment? Does she feel vibrationally to you like someone who really practices what she preaches? And she's like, oh, no, no, like, she's not even a healthy person. She's not very healthy. Like, it's, you know, I don't even know why she's a nutritionist, or if she got an education at it or what. And so I kind of laughed because I knew I was doing the show about this today. And I just was talking to her about how that's what we have to start caring about. Humanity has to start to really pay attention to the integrity of the being that's bringing the message, whatever that message may be. So if, for example, I'm a nutritionist and I don't practice healthy practices myself, and I'm just telling everyone what to do based on just random things I'm coming up with, but I don't really understand health and I don't really live health, I'm out of alignment. I'm not really aligning with what I'm speaking about. And so therefore, there's going to be more room to have issues and things coming in that aren't really going to make sense for the goal. So if we were in the education system and we have a PE teacher and they're overweight, they're lazy, they've got, you know, issues, they don't even like children, they just are waiting that next 2 years to retire. Another example that's real that someone just told me about, and they're just waiting to get that retirement pay. This is, again, an example of how the children that are around this person, and that person's yelling at them and telling them what to do, but they're not really practicing what they say. They're not participating. They're not healthy. The children really, it's going to be a struggle for them to respect this leader because this leader is not in alignment. And that's what the topic today is all about, is how do we participate in the shift, encouraging leaders to actually be in alignment, and how are we as society participating and enabling these controller energies to stay right where they are? Well, we have to look into a lot of different factors. We can look into our rule system. We have all these rules and all these belief systems and things that we cling to, and we create all these rules to protect ourselves. In essence, these rules often enslave the very ones who created them while enslaving a lot of others at the same time. And so we have to look into this. Like, if we're creating these rules that aren't really serving anyone, including the leader who's supposed to be explaining everything to us, and then we're angry at children who don't really respect the leadership, they don't respect the teachers, maybe they don't really want to participate, I feel like a big part of the shift will come from the fact when we wake up to realize that these children are very intelligent. And it's kind of like taking, if you take a pack of dogs, wild dogs, children, to me, it's very similar energy. If you have dogs and they are all hanging out, they quickly establish and figure out who the leader is. The leader is that calm, assertive energy. They're going to be the alpha leader every time. And so in different structures, like our education, our healthcare, in religion, whatever creation you want to make for a system, there's that same energy going on. So sometimes these leaders that are bullies, they will kind of intimidate and push people around to get a sense of being in charge, and maybe not even a sense. Many times these are the ones that are in charge. But the ones that are being submissive, they can feel it instantly when something's out of alignment. The difference is that if they don't do anything about it, they don't say anything about it, they don't express their truth, they don't challenge that misalignment, then this is how we as society participate in keeping it just the way it is. So today, I feel like the big topic here is to help us each see how we have power in shifting this stuff. If we are going to complain about something, then we need to look at our own part in how we are participating in it. And we could look at how we have power to shift and change it. And if we're not wanting to be in our power and we don't want to speak our truth and we just are intimidated and we tuck our tail and we just accept whatever we're told, then we're enabling it. We're actually participating in the misalignment. And so part of being being a shift leader, and part of what's going to help us to change these structures is those that will have enough courage to speak truth about it, those that will have the courage to shine the light on those situations and to actually stand up for what is right and just. And so if we're just complaining about what's going on in our government, which I hear it all the time, people love to complain about things, but then I watch them, and the ones that are complaining about how there's no integrity, there's no compassion, there's no care, there's no honesty. And honestly, as I observe many humans that are speaking this, I watch how they are living their lives and how there's no honesty, there's no compassion, they're not always having integrity. And so the way I see it is that as we want, if we're ready to truly evolve this, we have to be the change that we're seeking. So if I am upset about something, the highest form of shift will be for me to focus inward on how can I be that? How can I be that aligned leader? How can I speak with truth? How can I show compassion? How can I have patience and respect and have integrity? And so the people that don't want to look into that, they often will be angry and frustrated by this mirror. It's an energetic mirror. Everything that comes into our life is mirroring something to us. It's all interconnected. So if I'm really angry and lashing out about something and I'm not tuning in to see what this is mirroring to me, I can often miss an opportunity for greater expansion and understanding of myself. So if us, those of us that are in this country and we're angry about things that are happening on the planet, if we sit back and we do nothing except complain, we are participating in the vibrational misalignment of harmony and peace and justice. But if we can see and observe that things are out of alignment, yet we keep our own thoughts consistently focused on alignment, on love, on unity, on compassion, on respect, integrity, and we're living in that flow, we're maintaining that vibrational alignment, then we have a greater impact to actually shift that structure away from this structure that's not working towards this structure that we are calling in, that we're ready to co-create. And that's vibrationally going to be very powerful. So if each of us were practicing this together, if every one of you listening today really claimed complete ownership over your own energy, your own stuff, really looked into how am I participating in the misalignment? How is it that today, am I going to choose today to be authentic and live in my integrity? Am I going to challenge the misalignment around me? Or am I going to just tuck my tail, pretend it doesn't matter, and go home and talk shit about them? Or am I going to just be angry and bitter and frustrated and stressed and just be, you know, put out that vibration but do nothing? Or am I going to be just like those misaligned leaders and go and bully my family around when I get home? There's so many factors to it. So we have opportunities to really look into the greatest thing that's going to shift this planet situation will be when we each become accountable and responsible individuals. When I become Tanya is in charge of Tanya, and she's responsible for Tanya's energy and where I'm focusing my energy, I'm not going to blame anybody else for where my energy is. This is a huge part of a shift. Many humans are still in this place where they're blaming everybody else for their emotions. I'm angry. I hate you. It's your fault. You made me angry. Well, people can upset you. They can bring energy that can cause disruption, but we choose what we do with that. And so to really maintain that higher vibration, someone may upset you, but how do you handle that? What do you learn from it? How do you still maintain your alignment and still stay in that place of aligned leadership rather than become what you hate? And this is the fine line that we walk, because so many humans will start to hate something that's being done to them only to become it. They start to align with that anger and that hate, and they become that energy in a different form. And so I'm going to pause. Is there any questions or comments coming in, Amnon?
Not yet. I'm soliciting.
Okay, come on, guys. Let us know. Call in. I challenge someone to be brave and let us hear your voice and speak your truth today. This is a little test for you to really step into that place of leadership. So I encourage you to do that. So getting back to like leadership, this stuff can start very young as children. You can establish how children are taught very quickly if they're going to submit or they're going to take a leadership role. And often it's how they're treated in their family dynamic, how they're treated in that environment, and then how they are treated in their school environment and in their community. But we can really, as parents, help these children to embody that role of a leader more than causing them to feel like they have no power by making sure we're in alignment and that we really live with integrity. And even if they're not listening all the time, we're still mirroring that example to them. We're showing them the way. The parents that don't show the way and they just bully their kids around and bark orders and say, do it because I said, because I'm the one in charge. But yet parents aren't really showing integrity. Maybe they're yelling at their kids for lying, but they lie to their kids all the time. Maybe they're yelling at their kids for, you know, not owning their stuff and being responsible for their stuff, while parents sometimes aren't really letting them be responsible, and they're actually enabling them, and they're catering to all their misalignments, and they're giving to them when they shouldn't. So there's a lot of levels that we can look into early in life where we as parents are either helping support that growth into a potential leader, or we are sabotaging that growth by really teaching them misalignment and rewarding them for it, or punishing them in ways that aren't really in alignment as well. The spectrum is pretty vast of where we can go with this. But in essence, being an aligned leader is what is necessary to get us out of the situations we're in with so many of the structures that it is clear are not in alignment and are not thriving. So in order for us to heal what's broken, we have to first see that, we have to be honest about it, and then we have to have the leadership to stand up and speak about it, and not just talk, but actually speak about it and take action, take aligned action. So there's some that maybe they'll go out and protest and they're angry, and that's as far as they get. And then there's others who they see what's going on, and then they find a healthy, powerful way that they can create a change and cultivate a shift without having to really be violent or angry or aggressive about anything. And this is another path that we have available to us. I have personally witnessed misalignment in leadership in all different forms and structures of where a leader could possibly show up. And this is something that I feel we need to be really mindful of, because a lot of times people have been trained and conditioned very young. Many of you have been conditioned with belief systems to believe in certain people or places that this is the person. You just do what they say. Don't question authority. You don't mess with the government. You don't talk back to the minister. You don't mess with the principal at school. You do what they say. There's a lot of these belief systems we've been taught that really are not in alignment from the very, very beginning. And so, yes, we want to teach our children to show respect to everyone. That's a basic thing that an aligned parent will be teaching. But do we tell them that they shouldn't question authority, or that they shouldn't stand up for what they really believe is true and shouldn't speak their truth? I feel that that's one of the most important things to encourage a future leader to know they have permission to do. But what I observed and what I lived through was not that at all. It was you do what the misaligned adults say no matter what. And you just suck it up and you deal with it, because that's just the way it is. And this is what is running our country right now. This is what's really kind of running the world if we look around. A lot of energies that have intimidated and bullied are in charge. And there's a select few, really. If you look at the numbers on the planet, the numbers of people that are being oppressed and are suffering in some form compared to the numbers that are leading and ruling and controlling it, there's not a lot of the leadership that's there compared to the numbers that are being controlled. So if we just all woke up today and really took back our power and started to really speak our truth, whatever opportunity that truth is able to be given, imagine the amazing shift in evolution that we would have so fast. But this is going to have to come from many, many humans awakening into their own power and speaking. and not being afraid to anymore.